It's clear from this morning's jobs report that the economy still isn't creating enough jobs. You talk to job creators around the country like we have, they'll tell you that the overtaxing, overregulating, and overspending that's going on here in Washington is creating uncertainty and holding them back. This week, House Republicans met with the president, urged him to change course and to work with us on our plan for new jobs and economic growth in our country. And we hope he'll take us up on our invitation. If we're serious about creating jobs in America, we can't raise taxes on the very people who create jobs and keep spending money that we don't have. Yesterday, Moody's reinforced our point with that an increase in the debt limit without major spending cuts will hurt our economy and destroy jobs. That's why we said the spending cuts must increase or must accompany any increase in the debt limit. One look at the jobs report should be enough to show the White House it's time to get serious about cutting spending and dealing with our ailing economy.
Good morning. If there were ever a time that we need to start focusing on jobs, this is it. If there were ever an indicator that we actually need to start having a plan to grow jobs, this is it. And the House Republicans unveiled our plan for America's job creators last week. We are serious about growing this economy. We are serious about reinstilling some optimism on the part of small businesses and the middle class in this country. This president continues to give speeches as if he is there for the middle class and the small businesses, but somehow the rhetoric falls short because the actions have seemed to hinder job growth and entrepreneurial activity. We want to continue to push forward in this area and welcome the president finally to join us so that we can get America back to work.
You heard from the speaker and the leader on the facts of what are out there. One of the things, when you look at the jobs report, you sit back and wonder why. You saw a Keynesian view of more government spending, from a stimulus to a QE1 and QE2. Not only did the voters disagree with it, now the numbers have disagreed with it. Today, it takes the average unemployed 39.7 weeks to find a job. You have had been 28 straight months with unemployment above 8%. You look back and wonder why. It's been more than 750 days, and the Democrats have not passed a budget. Why would you wait without a long-term plan? This is a time for Harry Reid. This is a time for the president to put the partisanship aside and put the country first. There are a number of bills the House Republicans have actually have passed to roll back regulations, to focus on small business. 70% of all new jobs start through small business. Let's put people before politics, and let's put this country back to work.
Well, another month and another data point on the failure of Obamanomics. The administration still doesn't seem to understand that you cannot spend, borrow, tax, and bail out your way to economic prosperity. If you look at the history of recessions in the post-war era, you have never seen a longer recession attached to a more tepid recovery than that which is occurring under President Barack Obama. By any historic standard, this nation ought to be back to work. There ought to be more money in the pockets of American families to send their kids to college, to start a small business. But there isn't. Again, it is another data point on their failure. It's one of the reasons why just last week, as our leader said, Republicans announced their plan for America's job creators. What the administration doesn't understand that one of the biggest impediments to job creation today is the lack of confidence. The lack of confidence in the future that comes from an administration where regulators have gone wild, from an administration threatening the largest single tax increase in America's history, and an administration that doesn't take seriously the debt that is threatening our job creators, threatening our national security, and threatening future generations. Our job creators are keeping capital on the sidelines because they know historic levels of debt lead to historic levels of taxation, which lead to historic levels of unemployment. That's why Republicans are moving. And if we put forth a budget that would solve our debt crisis, tax reform, fairer, flatter, simpler, more competitive tax code, and to take care of the regulatory burden so that job creators know that they have the confidence to go out and risk capital and put America back to work.
Unemployment shouldn't be rising in America. For me, there's two main takeaways from these numbers that we heard this morning. One is that the borrow, spend, bailout policies aren't working, and that the stimulus never worked. In fact, since President Obama took office, we've lost 2.5 million jobs in America. Secondly, we need a pro-growth agenda. We need to look at America's competitiveness and get Americans back to work. It means helping our entrepreneurs. It means unleashing those innovators. And let's be honest about the debt burden and the impact that it is on our economy. Let's recognize that rising gasoline prices are hurting our economy. Let's start unleashing American energy. It's one of the best ways, the quickest ways that we could get America back to work. And everywhere I go, people continue to highlight the regulations that are making it difficult for them to move forward on anything. One person put it to me this way. He said, "Kathy, there is an elephant in the middle of the road. It's the federal government, and it's getting harder and harder to get around that elephant." You know, I spent 13 years working in a family business, and I understand the rewards as well as the heartaches. And during this time, this is when we need to be helping our small businesses and giving them that certainty so that they will be willing to take a risk. And as was mentioned earlier, 70% of new jobs are driven by our small businesses. And we need to move forward on those policies that will give our small businesses the certainty to create those jobs.
We've had 27 jobs reports since the stimulus. And every one of those job reports has been underwhelming. And think about that. It's not 5 reports. It's not 10. It's not 15. It's not 20. It's 27 jobs reports, and every one says that the program is underwhelming. And at one point, you have to ask and answer this question. When will the White House realize that their underperformance and lack of planning and failure is a real obstacle to job creation? House Republicans have articulated a wide-ranging set of alternatives that are thoughtful and robust and dynamic and that can fundamentally change the trajectory of this economy, just without question. And I think the White House has to realize at this point, it is my hope that they realize at this point, that simply hope for a change is not an economic policy.
I have the privilege of serving in the 19th Congressional District of New York, and about 3 weeks ago, we had a meeting in my home county of Westchester County of the Westchester County Association, which consists of local businessmen and women, entrepreneurs, local government officials, and also students. We have a wide range of our citizens represented there, and I asked them a question, a simple question. Did any members of the audience feel that New York State's own high tax, high regulation model had led to increased opportunity and development of the economy and of growth in New York? And I can tell you that not one hand was raised. And they sent a clear message to the members of Congress who were present at that breakfast. And they're sending a clear message that we share in the House Republican Conference, that we are sending to President Obama, to our administration, and to the Senate. And that message is that we must tackle the challenges that we face without raising the burdens on the American people of taxes and regulation. And we do have a plan. We have presented a plan for prosperity and job growth. And I hope and trust that President Obama, the administration, and the Senate will work together with us to assure that Americans have the confidence and the working capital that they need to know that they will not be burdened and they won't be punished for success and that they will have growth, jobs, and opportunity.